This may look like a boring old beige 286 PC, but the important thing about it is that it's running an operating system which everyone else has forgotten about, and which there is no trace of existing at all on the internet. It was released in 1996 and was intended to be a competitor to Microsoft Windows, but it's not OS 2, it's OS 5. And while Windows and OS 2 came on CD-ROMs and could take up several hundred megabytes of hard drive space when fully installed, there are two versions of OS 5 known to exist, and they both fit on a single 720K floppy disk. And while the contemporaneous versions of Windows and OS 2 required at least a 486 to run well, OS 5 can run on any PC with at least 512K of RAM, even an original IBM PC. So it runs perfectly fine on this 12 MHz 286. The first version of it was OS 5 Desktop version 1.0, released on February 1st, 1996. The zip file it came in was only 188K. The description says OS 5 Desktop 1.0 is a DOS shell program which operates similar to the OS 2 or Windows desktop. It includes a file manager, interface for most popular DOS commands, a checkbook register, simple drawing program, calculator, chart and graph creator, and time display. It was written by John Poole, and it was shareware with a registration fee of $23. Here's the original order form. It was released by John Poole Software of Jacksonville, Florida. It cost $20 plus $2.95 for shipping. And it was available on either 720K 3.5 or 360K 5.25 inch floppy disk. Now let's run it. You just type desktop from the DOS prompt. We see something that looks similar to the Windows logo, but it is not Windows. We go to About, it says John Poole Software presents Operating System 5 Desktop, a DOS-based graphic user interface. But this is not actually running in graphics mode. This is running entirely in text mode, but yet it has windows that you can drag around with buttons on them. You can minimize, maximize. These are icons down here, and that brings up a control panel. It says OS 5 Windows control panel, but again, this is not Windows. And we can look at some of the programs here. It has a text editor, version 2.0. And we can start typing, or we can load a file here. Let's load that README file. And there it is. File information says it's 332 bytes. And we can cut, copy, and paste, of course. So I can click and drag to select the text of the mouse and do copy. And then go down here and paste it. Now let's look at the next program it has, ClickDraw. This is a very simple drawing program. It just draws a block wherever you click the mouse. So it's a bit tedious, but you could use it to draw simple lines and illustrations and artwork and whatever else you want to do. All in text mode. But because this is a multitasking interface, I can minimize it and go run something else, such as the calculator, which can't divide by zero. So I'll minimize the calculator and go back to the drawing program. In fact, I'll resize the drawing program and restore the calculator. So now we have both on the screen at the same time, and I can even run the check manager. It's not quite Quicken, but it still could be useful. And I'll close that. No, I don't want to save the records. How about the chart program? We can graph a chart. This is where it actually does go into graphics mode, but it's only CGA graphics, so again, this could run perfectly well on original IBM PC. And we're back to our chart program, our calculator. I'll minimize the chart program. minimize the calculator and the drawing program. So now we have multiple icons. We can click and drag the icons. And we go into the system here. We already saw the control panel. And there it is. We can change the colors and we get different desktop backgrounds. For example, you remember the bricks from Windows 3.1. Well, we have a text mode version of bricks as well. Also have a file manager and different operations here like copy, delete, edit, move, print, rename, even go out to a DOS prompt. So we're at DOS now and we can exit back to OS 5 and close the file manager. Other DOS tools here. These are shortcuts for running the utilities that DOS came with, such as scan disk and defrag. You can do a directory tree. And there it shows our directory tree. I can even minimize the tools. And we also have a clock, of course. You can change it to 24 hours and add a date, and it has an alarm. And that's about it for OS 5 version 1.0. Now let's take a look at version 1.1. The second, and as far as I know, final version of OS 5 that was also released in 1996. It's version 1.1. The description says a fast and easy to use multitasking environment program for the home and office. OS 5 Desktop's user-friendly interface enables you to handle and organize your DOS system more efficiently. Desktop has everything from a calculator to a clock and helpful tools to assist you in your everyday computing life. Full interface program with many special features and functions that only programs such as GeoWorks Ensemble, Deskmate, and Windows can offer. And here it says requires DOS 3.1 or greater. And it says it's shareware. Try before you buy software. If you would like to continue to use OS 5 Desktop after the 30-day evaluation period, you must register your copy. And this time it comes with a full license in all caps. And the order form. Again, the price is $20 plus shipping. And John Poole had an email address through CompuServe, and that's where I found OS 5 Desktop on. I don't know if it's been archived anywhere else ever since. So let's run version 1.1 of OS 5. Again, it briefly shows something similar to the Windows logo. This time the mouse cursor is a little bit different. And we have an about screen that says John Poole Software presents Operating System 5 Desktop version 1.1, a DOS-based graphic user interface running in standard mode, available memory 2670K. Again, we have some applications here. Instead of an editor, this time we have a notepad, which is a little bit simpler of a program, but it does look a little more visually appealing, and it looks like the menus are more full-featured now. So let's try loading the same README file in it. And again, we get cut, copy, paste, we get word wrap, we get a search function. So the same basic features as we had before in the editor. And this time I can just minimize it. And again, it has a control panel, which looks basically the same as before. Has an option for three-dimensional and window shadow, which as you can see helps make it look more graphical even though this is only running in text mode. Go back to the editor and close out of that. Now we can run again the calculator, pretty much the same as before. Oops. Didn't want that. check manager just like before. We also have the chart program. So that's pretty much the same as last time. You can minimize that. And again, we can exit to the DOS prompt. And this time it just appears right on the screen there. And we can exit back into OS 5. And system, we have a file seek function now. Let's see what that does. Well, it just lists the files that fit the search criteria. So, let me see, readme.star. And it just lists that one readme file. So, pretty basic file search function. Also get a file manager, this time version 1.02. And it's a little bit different this time. You double click on a program and it brings up this tools menu listing all the options you can do with it. So, unfortunately you can't click and drag to select multiple files. So, still quite basic of a file manager. We can maximize it to fit the full screen, bring it down to that size, and minimize it. Again, we have DOS tools, including a shredder, whatever that is. And finally, the clock, which we can also add the date, and this time we can make it bigger or smaller. Again, we can drag it around the screen. You can minimize it to an icon. And let's see, arrange icons. Okay, it looks like that just opening up everything. Oh, that's interesting. It opened up everything it can do. So we have our notepad here. Close that. The chart program. We got the clock. Oh, the clock shows the time in the icon. So that's nice. You can even cover up one icon with another. So, a very interesting concept at applying Windows and icons in a text mode interface, which is something you normally only saw in Windows or OS 2 or those other programs that mentioned like GeoWorks and Deskmate. So it's a quite interesting use of the text mode to simulate a graphical interface. So that's OS 5 version 1.1, the only other version of it that I know of. But you may have noticed this file here, which was in both versions of OS 5, vbdrt10.exe. That stands for Visual Basic for DOS Runtime version 1.0. And yes, Microsoft did actually release a version of Visual Basic for DOS. It actually came after they released the Windows version because there was still enough demand for DOS applications back in 1992 when this was from, but they only ever made one version of it, 1.0. And Visual Basic for DOS is what provided the windowing system used in OS 5. With these graphical elements that looks like the close button and the minimize button and the shadows, and you can rearrange the windows and resize them and have multiple overlapping windows on the screen. This is all done by Visual Basic. See, even the shadow overlaps and you can still see what's underneath it. So I think it's a really neat use of DOS text mode to make it look like a graphical interface. There's just one thing I want to try here. First, I'll have to exit back to DOS. That is, what will happen if we try to run it in 43-line EGA mode? And yes, it does look like it's working, and we get more screen real estate. See, that notepad used to take up the entire screen, now it only takes up that much. So we have more room on our screen for other windows and applications, such as the control panel. I can load the check manager, and can almost fit all three here on the screen, because we're now running in EGA text mode, which gives us 43 lines. And I bet if I exited out of OS 5 and switched to 50 line VGA text mode, that would give us even more space this time. You can see if I run the notepad, it looks even smaller. Although the text is harder to read now because it's smaller text on the screen. We're fitting more content in the same visual area. So just like in a graphical interface, that makes the text smaller. But we do get more screen real estate for all these different programs. I just want to check one more thing. I want to see if this available memory thing is actually accurate or if it's just making it up. So currently it says 2670K available memory. Now I'll get back out to DOS and I'll run OS 5 from within stupid DOS, which should take up some of that available memory. So about now it's slightly less, so it does appear to be somewhat of an accurate count. And I know people are going to say it's not a complete operating system because it runs from within DOS and it can only run the limited amount of programs it originally came with. But you have to remember how small it is. Version 1.0 of OS 5 only took up about 330K. And if I look at version 1.1, that's actually smaller at 299K. So that's why both of them can fit on a single 720K floppy disk. And I think John Poole was way ahead of his time, because what are people doing today with old vintage PCs like this? They're trying to add new features and functions and capabilities to old machines. And that's what he was doing with OS 5 all the way back in 1996. So if you watch this video and you can find some way to contact Mr. Poole, if he's still around, you can tell him you heard of it through this video in the year 2023. And I'll include links in the description to download both versions of OS 5, 1.0 and 1.1, although you may need an older PC or may need to use DOSBox in order to run it, because I tried running it from within Windows XP on a Core 2 Duo machine and it just crashed, it didn't even start up. But I think it's best experienced on an old computer like this anyway, to get the true experience. So this has been possibly the first time OS 5 has ever been seen online since 1996. Certainly, I can't find it anywhere else on the internet. But I think it deserves to be remembered, so you can do your part by downloading it and exploring it for yourself.